in this box is one of the hottest products that is no longer available because they're sold out. Yes, we're talking about the Audio-Technica 60th anniversary SoundBurger, the Bluetooth portable record player. My name is Mick Stillone. Stick around while we put the Bluetooth turntable through its paces. We'll connect it to a HiFi system. We'll connect it to Bluetooth speakers, and we will connect it to Bluetooth headphones and see just how good, how practical, and how easy to live with this Bluetooth turntable is. The amount of hype over this little product is quite amazing. Limited quantities was made worldwide, only 7,000, and this one here is 2,775 out of 7,000. This is a portable Bluetooth record player. You can attach it via a supplied cable, 3.5mm to stereo RCA, to a sound system. So yes, you can use this in your home. You can use it with a sound system, which we will try. You can wirelessly connect this via Bluetooth to any Bluetooth speaker. You can also connect it to your Bluetooth headphones. It's portable in every sense of the word. Pick it up, move it around, put it down, play a record. It ships with a locking pin that I took out. This will hold the tone arm in place so that it doesn't move around and damage the stylus. It has a release on the side, which opens up the turntable. And as you can see here, you have two buttons. Your power button, hold it, it'll turn on. And then you also have a speed select button, 33 and 45. When you press this and the light is solid, it'll be 45. When there's no light, it's going to be on 33. This is a belt drive turntable. Belt is inside the wheel. And to get access to that, should you need to replace the belt, you can remove the screws on the back and then you can replace the belt. And you can see also the electronics. Behind this little panel here, there's the rechargeable battery. This is part of the 60th anniversary for Audio-Technica. 60 years. That's a nice milestone. And in that 60 years, they've made some amazing products, such as record players, microphones, headphones, cartridges, some great cartridges. The cartridge ships with a little plastic protector. It's when you actually position this in its little tone arm lock, which is a clever device because the tone arm lock actually doubles as a record clamp. I'll show you that when I'm doing some demos. The needle itself doesn't hit the turntable, which is kind of good. So it is protected without that little plastic cap. Just be careful. And if you do damage the stylus, it's no big deal. These are readily available replacement styluses. So this is the tone arm holder that also doubles as a record clamp. You can also use the outer ring there for, you know, some of the old singles that might have had the need for the spacers. So I've connected the cable to an RCA input, just a standard RCA input line in. Don't use a phono, because if you use a phono, you're going to get distortion. And that is because this little turntable has a built-in phono and it'll attach to pretty much any sound system with an RCA input. We're going to turn on our amplifier. We want to make sure this works, not just for the novelty, but for someone that actually wants to keep a great little turntable and maybe keep it as a spare unit. Okay, so we've got our disc on, we've got the clamp in, the tone arm is all the way across, therefore it is hitting the switch and stopping the turntable from spinning around at the moment, and we're ready to go. This record's actually 45 RPM, so now I'm going to press the switch. So now that it's lit up, that means it's going to be 45. Let's give it a go.
That's pretty cool. That's very cool. And it sounds really good. Sounds really good.
No arguments with that. This is not a toy. This is full on. I wasn't expecting it to be this good. These products come out and they could almost be novelty. Something that you can have a bit of fun with. That sounds great. Sounds really, really good. So it is not a toy. It is full on a record player that has some very cool features.
That was actually really impressive. It took me by surprise.
If you have a look, let me grab this. If you have a look right there, you will see a little Bluetooth switch. That is what you press, and hopefully when we put a speaker in Bluetooth mode, it will connect and we'll see how easy it is. So let's give it a go. I love it when I get a surprise. I don't get that many surprises anymore. A little bit of Queen. I'm sure if anyone minds, you could use the money. Preparing mode to work, you've got to first of all take out the RCA cable or the 3.5mm jack. Take out the line cable and then you need to press and hold. There you go. You saw your little blink over there. So now I think it's in pairing mode. Listen. Oh, so that stopped blinking and that made a noise. Therefore, I think that worked. Well, that was not difficult.
So my criticism, there is no ability to hold the tone arm up when you're moving it across. It'd be nice if there was some kind of little tone arm lift that would allow you to gently put it down onto the record and also pick it up. Now, it could just be that I've got big fat fingers and I'm struggling to drop it where I want to drop it and line it up as nicely as I would like to line it up. And a few times I've sort of just accidentally bumped it or dropped it. And same thing when I'm picking it up, I just can't pick it up steadily enough to get it off the record without it actually making a nasty noise.
So lining it up, not that easy. It's very very sensitive.
Is this the real life, everybody?
That doesn't sound great when it does that, does it? No. I'll cut that bit out. Ouch.
Let's turn them on. Okay, so the headphones are on. If you can see, headphones are on. It's blinking and it's in Bluetooth mode. So let's press and hold this. All right. It's blinking. That's blinking. Are we going to get a connection? It's telling me Bluetooth connected. Headphone test. Volume down. Volume up. Don't knock the record player because it'll skip. But that's working an absolute treat. How good is that? I'm talking, but I can't hear you because the music's playing. I'm in the next room. It's loud and it's fantastic.
Nobody loves me.
Whew, it's cut out now, and we're on a different level, about 15 meters away. That's pretty good.
This portable Bluetooth turntable from Audio-Technica performs as good, if not better, than some turntables that we've listened to, easily up to $1,000. It does everything it says it can do, and it does it incredibly well. Attached to a Bluetooth speaker, attached to Bluetooth headphones,
attach it to a stereo system, and if you've got a headphone amp, attach it to a good pair of headphones. This will surprise you. My criticism, as I've mentioned earlier, is the sensitivity of the pickup, the tone arm. It does need a tone arm lifter, some ability to be able to position the stylus on the track you want to listen to so that you can drop it down without scratching your record. You know, the technology that is in this is not new. There are portable Bluetooth turntables that are out there. But like everything that Audio-Technica does, the build quality is very, very good for the price. Very good for the price. And it performs well, well above its price point in the real world. You know, with the availability of streaming services, is this going to be a better solution than listening to streaming via my phone onto headphones? Is that what it's about? Or are playing records a part of socializing, a part of being with friends and enjoying music together? I think that's where this will really come into its own. It's about being able to sit with your mates, sit with your family, sit with your loved ones, sit in the park, sit in the patio, sit in the living space, take it on a road trip if you want to, whack on some vinyl and just enjoy music. The social element of playing records is fantastic. None of that is lost on this little player. Yeah, it's small. Yeah, it's Bluetooth. But it works. It sounds great. It's a hell of a lot of fun. I want one. They're sold out. And I'm pretty sure that if everyone writes to Audio-Technica, send them an email and say, make more of these products. Please, sir, can I have some more? Thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed the videos. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that bell icon. And we'll see you the next time we create a video. Thank you very much for your time. Cheers.
I see a little silhouette of a man.
Scaramouche, Scaramouche, will you do the fandango?
Thunderbolt and lightning, very, very frightening me.
Galileo, Galileo,
Galileo, Galileo, Galileo
Figaro. Magnifico!
He's just a poor boy from a poor family, sparing his life from this monstrosity.
Easy come, easy go, will you let me go?
Bismillah!
No, we will not let you go.
Let him go!
Bismillah!
We will not let you go.
I like it. Well, what can you say? It's great. Look, it's even got rubberized, spongy little feet to absorb vibrations. I mean, that's pretty good. I think it's pretty good. Don't play it in the sun. If you play it in the sun, the record's gonna warp and the record's gonna melt. Don't leave records in your car. Although, if you go camping, that'd be pretty cool. But remember, records, they're shiny black discs. Don't like sun. Maybe the next model you make Audio-Technica, put a little arm lift in there. How hard could it be? I'd pay more for that. Makes it easier to find your track, easier to find the groove, easier to drop it down, easier to pick it up. Pretty good chance I won't break the stylus. Paid for itself already. Auto lift. Manual lift. I don't care. Just lift. Very good. That's really all I have to say, I think. I'm going to sign out now and listen to some records. So enjoy the SoundBurger by Audio-Technica. Don't know where you're going to find one. They're all gone. I kind of like the red. Do you like the red? It's well built. It's got a carry strap.